Hello everyone, this is Freya and welcome to a new episode of A Discovery of Nordic Witchcraft. In this episode, we are going to talk about the Sami, Mataraka, and the Norse, Frøya. Sami had her always on the tongue and in the heart. Akka means old woman, and in Finnish it means great grandmother or ancestress. Mattar, madder, holds the meaning of earth or ground. In Sami mythology, the goddess Mataraka is understood to be a feminine deity, the mother goddess from whom all people descend. She has a variety of domains, including the protection of mothers, women, and babies. When a new soul is created by Yggdrasil, the Sami creator god, he passes it to Mataraka, who gives the soul a body and then entrusts this newly ensouled being to her daughter Saraka, who will make sure that the correct human female becomes pregnant with the baby. In the primordial origin stories of the Sami, there was a strong bond between embodiment and ensoulment, as well as between the human and the animal kingdoms. The spheres of being were related via the goddess Mataraka, who is the Sami equivalent to Mother Earth. The most humble of the expressions of this goddess is rocks. It is significant that the Mother Earth goddess was a figure who represented the connections between human and animal births and the mythic realm. The fact that she and her daughters oversaw the incarnation of a new soul from the realm of spirit to the realm of earth suggests a sacred unity between the cosmos, the earthly realm, and human life. Mataraka's presence in the rocks and mountains of the earthly realm entices the imagination to ponder the ways in which life is connected to and dependent upon what comes before and after. This goddess received all manner of offerings, both through daily rituals at the home hearth, but also as a part of larger communal sacrifice rituals. Mataraka is the first Akka. She is the mother of the tribe, the ancestral mother, goddess of women and the children, she who gives humans their bodies. Receiving a human body is most likely the first Seder sorcery we receive at the beginning of our earthen adventure. Doesn't this vibrate immensely with the Norse goddess Frøya? And most likely tells us that Mataraka was a predecessor of our Norse Frøya. Frøya is the primary goddess of the Norse Vanir, the old earth-based deities. She is the embodiment of the green and gold fruitful earth, but she is also the one who entered the dark passage and walked down into the rocks. Like Frøya and her Valkyries, Mataraka receives souls sent down for incarnation by Yggdrasil. Frøya was, in my opinion, undoubtedly descendant from the Sami Akka goddesses affiliated with all earth matters. The influence of this goddess on Norwegian life is evinced by the fact that in Norway, professional midwives are also known as earth matters. This goddess traditionally lived under the gamme, the Sami hat, under the ground within easy reach for women in need of help. In the household, I locate this goddess inside the walls. They are what has a house standing. They represent the bone structure of a house, so there I feel the energy of the goddess is located. Outside, when I worship this goddess, I head to deep woods with large rocks. Sami often worship her at a seidi, a holy place that is typically a natural formation like a large boulder or a tree stump. They used to smear butter on birch bark and hanging it on tree branches. Worms were her sacred animals. It was believed that after the long winter, Mataraka woke up, and all the worms rose from the ground and danced in her honor. My favorite ways to connect with these goddesses are fresh air, bare feet, wild food, cold plunge, but especially smelling. Nostrils are the portals my soul will one day use to leave my body, and if I can make sure they have gathered throughout my life the cleanest and the most pristine of smells, I will then know Frøya will be waiting for me on the other side of those doorways. There is something about connecting with Frøya that harmonizes my internal rhythms, induces inner peace, and recharges me. In our modern world, we pick up frequencies that are not us. Electromagnetic frequencies from the tons of gadgets and appliances that surround us. In essence, we are constantly taking on frequencies that aren't very supportive of our minds and human bodies. Frequencies that conflict with our natural resonance. That is why 9 years ago I felt the need to move almost at the end of the world. This is a place of dark and brutal winters where the sun sinks into the Arctic Ocean in November and doesn't rise again for a long time. I have been chasing the gods for decades. That darkness has been the ending line for me. No more land in front of me, no more places to hide or distract me. The gods were all there in front of me. The worshipping of Frøya and Mataraka develops from the understanding we are just a piece of earth, or the land is our larger body. Throughout the span of 3 years of intense work here on this channel, the question I have received the most is, how can I deeply connect with the Norse goddess Frøya? Reality is, once we lose sight and connection with Frøya's blood and bones, the land, your body will slowly lose its integrity and stability, the fundamental pillars of living a Seidr life, a life filled with magic. And the goddess will only be found in the pages of old books you have not written. Frøya is the earth itself. She is the first feeling that every human being in the world would experience even before understanding and seeing other people. So to connect to her, we need to remember. And in this land, at the end of the world, barren and bare, with very little distractions, I have remembered. Though the majority live in a radically different looking world, the needs of our bodies and spirits are the same as the ancestors. What does it mean to really belong to a place? It means to allow the sacred ways to survive by writing your own book. Thank you so very much for watching this video. Thanks for spending some of your time here with me today. It's been truly appreciated, and I'll see you all in my next video. Tack så mycket. Hej då. Just gave me a sign.